The city has only allowed us 500. We're gonna say there's 500 showing up.
It will be huge and they'll be wearing very little. 10 News was the first to tell you about the Silkies hike when it was just an idea. Military reporter Hannah Mullins has the serious side of a veteran's humorous march.
You'll see a lot of muscle and some interesting sights, but the whole point is to make each other laugh.
Stay together, back.
These guys are almost too close.
Someone should have showered.
And they seem a little too confident as they bask in their brawn.
I'm so hetero, it hurts.
He can't go 2 seconds without hitting on a woman.
You wanna get some footage with you and the guys?
On Saturday, they'll strip down.
All right.
Not all the way, just to their silkies. They're so small, they leave little to the imagination.
Such a cheater.
Donnie O'Malley had his friends' backs on the battlefield, but what threatens vets on home soil isn't as easy to see as bullets and bombs.
Social isolation is what many suicides have in common.
His friend became one of about 20 vets a day who take their own lives.
It's got me right in the heart.
He formed the nonprofit Irreverent Warriors and launched the first Silkies hike 2 years ago.
Why am I here? Why are they not here?
Enemies ravaged Shane Crutchen's unit. 19 of his Marine brothers were killed in action. The funerals didn't stop back home.
Why did I lose him here? Why didn't he reach out?
Then he didn't reach out. His most agonizing battle wound was in his heart, and he nearly became a stat when he flatlined. But being back around fellow vets, he can talk about it, even joke.
The Taliban couldn't even kill me, and then I couldn't even kill myself. I'm like, it's gonna be my outcome.
Laughter is natural to us.
The camaraderie really comes easily. O'Malley introduced these vets just before the interview. He says the hikes have united 11,000 vets across the country.
There have been at least several dozen people who have said to me, this event saved their life.
It's coming back to where it all started. Hundreds who have served will storm the streets of San Diego. They'll raise eyebrows and stop traffic.
Don't worry, sir, I'm a Purple Heart recipient.
But they'll get some things off their chest and laugh until it hurts. Hannah Mullins, 10 News.
Fighting pain with humor. A festival starts this Saturday morning at 8 at De Anza Cove. The hike, which is for service members and vets, kicks off at 11, but anybody can be there to cheer them on.
Yep.